So good morning students, welcome to our next lecture of Path 354, that is diseases of papaya. We are starting with our first disease, that is foot rot, that is also known as a stem rot of papaya. Causal organism is Pythium aphanidermatum. Usually, as you all know, that Pythium, Phytophthora, Sclerotium, Rhizoctonia and Fusarium, these all are known to be the soil borne pathogen which causing adverse infection in the heavy moist condition of the soil. That Pythium majorly having a systemic infection and entry through the roots and causes the systemic infection to the vascular tissue. As you can see in the upper image, that the complete destruction or blackish discoloration of the roots can be seen here, and the lower portion, that is known to be the collar region of the papaya plant, so it becomes blackish in manner, or maybe known to be the rotting process starts, that is known as a foot rot. When a lower portion of the stem seems to be undergoes under process of the rotting, so that is known as a foot portion of the plant, so that's why it is known as a foot rot, also known as stem rot. So particularly the infection starts from the bottom, that is from the soil, and multiplies in the region of vascular tissue. So foot rot, also known as a stem rot, the multiple infection occurs in the vascular tissues to cause the systemic infection to the plant. You can see here also in the lower image, bottom image. So if you scrap the upper layer of the stem, so you can see the internal brownish or blackish discoloration of the vascular tissue. This resembles the presence of the pathogen inside the tissues and inside the stem. So sometimes it causes the is physiological stress to the plants and development of the plant, adversely effect on the development of the plant, and maybe sometimes causes the death of the plant. So that is the important disease in case of the papaya, that is foot rot and the stem rot. Primary source of infection is by dormant mycelium from soil, because the Pythium origins from the soil, and the secondary spread of pathogen by conidia through irrigation water. So basically this is the major factor here which is responsible for the spreading of the pathogen by irrigation water. So this is about the foot rot, also known as the stem rot of papaya. Next disease, that is leaf curl of papaya. So this is a viral disease. Causal organism is papaya leaf curl virus. So we all know that the leaf curl pathogen basically origins from the planting material, as well as it may be transmitted by any vector. So here the majorly the transmission in case of the leaf curl, that is caused by white fly Bamassia tabaci. So basically when the origin of the virus may be the planting material, in initial cultivation or initial growth of the plant, so maybe it seems to be normal development of the plant, but certainly when the plant grows further within 1 month or after 2 months, so it may be seems to be heavy curling. You can see here in the both the images, heavy curling, twisting of the leaves, and adversely effect on the development physiology of the plant. So, or sometimes maybe the higher plants, fully grown plants of the 3 months, 4 months, 5 months plant. So maybe sometimes it may be carries by the white flies, that is the vector, from one infected plant to the healthy plants or healthy fields. So sometimes it maybe the transmission is responsible, or a primary infection maybe from the planting material is responsible. The symptoms you can see in the picture in the images, that the heavily curling, twisting, puckering of the plants, or maybe that is known to be the mummification of the plant, because of the leaves. The normal size of the papaya leaves, you have observed so many times that a big size of the papaya leaves can be seen, but in this case you can see here totally reduction in the size, mummification of the leaves, and the heavily curling, twisting and puckering of the rolling of the particular leaf lamina, and causing the adverse effect on the physiology of the plant, which causes the damages to the flowering and the development of the fruits. So this is about the leaf curl of papaya. Transmission here, the major role of the transmission, because this is a viral disease, so transmission majorly occurs by white fly known as a Bamesia tabae. So this is about the leaf curl. Next disease of papaya, the very important disease, also a viral disease known as mosaic. So it's a common disease in all types of varieties of the papaya. So majorly occurs some of the symptoms on the leaves. Causal organism is papaya mosaic virus, PMV. As same in the case of the tobacco, we have seen the same kind of symptoms can be appear on the leaf lamina. So you can see here the pleuritic patches developed in between the veins, means known as interveinal chlorosis. So veins, you can see the veins clearly in the initial cases. It is the starting stage. You can see in the lower image, it's a starting stage of the mosaic disease, and the pleuritic patches started to be developed in between the veins. In the tissues of the leaves, so you can see the vein clearly. So venal, intervenal chlorosis can be seen in the initial case of the symptom, and then you can see in the upper image, so complete chloratic patches are occurs on the particular infected leaves along with some blister like appearance. So that's we have also discussed in the tobacco mosaic. So blister like appearance on the leaf, so this is a plain surface of the leaf converted into some kind of raised patches on the leaf surfaces. So this is known to be the blister like appearance on the leaf, so along with the complete chlorosis of the leaves. So this further causes the drying of the leaves, maybe the shedding of the leaves, heavily adversely affect on the development of the plants and the stunting the growth of the plant. Maybe sometimes causes the adverse effect on the genetical development, that is the flowering and the fruiting. So sometimes maybe immaturely the ripening of the fruit. So these are of the some of the other factors which are to be shown on the mosaic infected papaya plant. So these are about the mosaic symptoms. Basically, this mosaic virus majorly transmitted by the vector that is aphid, but also some of the factors which are responsible in case of this mosaic transmission, that is the sap transmission, and if any horticultural practices are there, it may be some kind of pruning, grafting, or maybe some kind of practices are there, so maybe responsible for the transmission of the virus from one plant to another plant, means from the infected plants to the healthy plant. So sap is also responsible. When if due to the cyclonic waves, when one branch of the plant comes in contact with the other branch, or one leaf, infected leaf comes in contact with the other healthy leaves, so maybe the sap, maybe cell sap, which is to be transferred from one infected plant to the healthy plant. So that's why the sap transmission is responsible. Horticultural tools and implements are responsible. Or maybe horticultural practices are responsible for the virus transmission. And also the last factor and the major factor, that is the aphid. Aphid vector is the most of all the species are responsible for the mosaic virus transmission of papaya. So this is about the mosaic of the papaya. Last disease of the papaya is papaya ring spot virus. So this is also a viral disease. Majorly the papaya plants are mostly susceptible to the viruses. So causal organism is papaya ring spot virus, so PRSV. So basically in case of this, the most of all prominent symptoms can be seen in case of when the fruit formation is there. So somewhat it is to be resembles as on the mature as well as immature fruits. You can see in the image. So you can see that circular ring patterns, one above the other, one second ring, third ring, one above the other, ring patterns are developed onto the surface of the fruit. So that's why it is known to be the ring spot. So this is a viral disease. Infection is systemic. Virus origins from the planting material as well as the transmission carries by the aphid from the healthy plants to the infected plants. But the resemble or identifying symptoms can be seen only at the development of the fruit, that is particularly immature as well as the mature fruit. So you can see here that it's an immature fruit, not the mature fruit, but prematurely yellowing can be seen. Prematurely looks like a ripened fruit, but it is not a ripened fruit. Immaturely yellowing due to the viral infection can be seen, and the external surface having the ring type pattern one above the other. So that's why it is known to be the ring spots virus or ring spot disease of the papaya. So basically internal pulp becomes cloddy or it becomes thick. If you see in normal cases of the papaya pulp, so it's a very soft when the maturity is there, or sometimes if immature is there. But in this case of infection of the ring spot virus, so papaya pulp internally becomes very cloddy, or maybe in the clots or tumor type appearance, or maybe sometimes hard pulp can be developed inside this particular papaya fruit. So these are some of the symptoms, external as well as internal symptoms can be seen in case of this papaya ring spot, which is caused by papaya ring spot virus. Transmission is majorly occurs by the vector that is known as aphid, Aphis gossypii and Aphis crassiora. So these are the transmission vector responsible for, or the species of the aphids. So this is about the diseases of the papaya. First is fungal disease, that is the foot rot, also known as stem rot, and the others are the three major viral disease: leaf curl, mosaic and the ring spot. So now we are moving towards our next crop, that is important fruit cash crop, that is pomegranate. So basically this is the most important crop in the horticultural in our area, in the case of the horticulture in our area, and the most important disease which causing heavily damaging destructive effects from last 7 to 10 years, the most important disease, that is bacterial blight or also known as oily spot of pomegranate. So it's a very important from last 5 to 7 to 10 years, the oily spot causal organism is Xanthomonas axonopodis pathovers punici. So the basic factors in case of this oily spot, the major bacteria, that is Xanthomonas, which develops toxin that is known to be a Xanthomonadine, having adversely effect on the development of the plant, starting with one by one symptoms which is to be can be seen on the plant. So basically you can see here, so it's are not the particular symptom, but the cracking of the stem part, so it can be seen resembles on the, or maybe lesions to be developed, or blackish lesions develops on the stem. But the most prominent part starts from the leaves and then towards the fruits. So this kind of oily blackish patches develops on the leaves, which may be converted into blighted patches on the leaves also. But when it migrates, the pathogen migrates or maybe causes infection to the fruits, so this kind of circular to irregular blackish patches, spot converted into blackish patches, bigger size patches, are to be developed on the surface of the fruit. So the oily means it resembles like this when it attached to the outer surface of the fruit, so it's a shiny pattern of the blackish spot. So that's why it is known to be the oily patches, or a greasy, when if a certain kind of grease, we have observed the greasy pattern or oily patches of any kind of oil when the submerge on any surface, so it may be looks like a shiny part. So such kind of appearance can be seen on the external surface of the fruit. Sorry. So this kind of circular pattern spots or lesions which is converted in, you can see in the next next picture or image, so which converted into big size lesions that are to be developed by the support of the temperature as well as humidity and external factors. So that kind of external patches or bigger size patches develops on the fruit, which tends to the cracking, small crackings. You can see here the crackings of the fruits. And then in the third picture, you can see the when the fruits are to be at the maturity stage or immaturity stage, it resembles some kind of big cracks to the fruits. You can see here these kind of cracks. So this resembles as a Y alphabet. So normally, if you observe in the pomegranate field, L shape or Y shape means L is alphabet, English alphabet, and the Y shape, Y alphabet shaped spots can be arises on the fruits where to be the crackings are observed. So this kind of crackings of the fruit can be seen, which resembles to the external infection from the external germs, which causes the rotting of the fruit and heavily dropping of the fruit. So you can see here also this kind of the crackings occurs to the fruit, usually L or Y shape, and certainly the external infection germs occurs to the rotting of the fruit, immaturely or maturity of the fruit. It doesn't matter the maturity or immaturity of the fruit, and it occurs at any time of the fruit development. So this is a major factor in recent years in case of the pomegranate development or the cultivation, which causes the heavy losses sometimes in some places, maybe 100% losses to by this oily spot. So these are the some of the important diseases, important factors related with the symptoms in case of the diseases of pomegranate. Primary source of infection by the infected cuttings or infected planting material. Basically, the infected planting material is responsible for this disease from Xanthomonas. And secondary source of infection by the wind. So bacterium may be sprayed by the wind and the rain splashes. So these are two factors where the bacterium can be responsible for the secondary source of infection. So this is about the bacterial blight, also known as oily spot. Very important disease for your examination. Next disease, last disease of the pomegranate, that is wilt. Only two diseases are there in pomegranate, oily spot as well as the second is wilt. So wilt is this case of pomegranate, it's known to be the multi organism disease. So here you can see Ceratocystis fimbriata, Fusarium oxysporum, Rhizoctonia solani and nematodes. Means the causal organisms are multiple. There is no only one organism is there. As we have seen that Fusarium is only responsible for the wilt, but here you can see a multiple organism effect on the plant of the pomegranate to cause the wilting stage. So that is Ceratocystis, Fusarium, Rhizoctonia as well as nematodes from the soil are responsible. This all the factors are responsible for the wilting of the pomegranate. So in any case of the plant stage of the growth, so you can see here at the lower image, so this is the initial after plantation, after one to two months you can see the complete death of the plant. Systemic infection occurs by the Rhizoctonia, Ceratocystis and the Fusarium, also along with the damage to the roots by the nematodes to cause the systemic infection to the plant, to cause initial wilting stage of the plant. But also you can see here at fully developed plants tends to resembles as a wilting stage externally, physiological stress to the plant, then chlorosis of the leaves, then drying of the leaves, shedding of the leaves, total wilting of the branches, drying of the branches. And you can see here in the picture that the wilting stage occurs at the fruiting stage of the plant. Means wilting stage occurs at any stage, maybe any stage of the plant growth, maybe in the initial cases after 1 to 2 months, maybe in the baby plant, or maybe at the stage of the fully matured plant. So this is the heavy destructive disease along with the, when we are talking about the oily spot. So second disease is the wilt, which causing the adverse and destructive effect on the plant growth. So the multiple organism disease that is built, ceratocystis, fusarium, rhizoctonia, and nematodes. So basically primary source of infection is by through from soil, all the organism origin from the soil to cause the systemic infection to the plants. And secondary source of infection by majorly conidias from the by the water. So irrigation water are responsible, and some of the nematodes are also responsible for the adversely effect on the roots to causes the wilting stage. So this is about the diseases of papaya and diseases of pomegranate. In case of pomegranate, only oily spot and the wilt disease is important. Only two diseases are there in your syllabus, and both diseases in the case of the pomegranates are important for you. Out of which oily spot, that is bacterial blight, is the most important for your syllabus in the examination. So this is about the papaya and pomegranate diseases. In the next lecture, we will see about the diseases of tomato, which are the most important vegetable fruit crops in our